And she did this like a good mother and a good wife. But, okay, so for instance, she had to be very sexually pleasing to her husband so that he wouldn't go and have sex with a communism. First thing you go to when the wife tells you. But if you were too sexy, then you would pervert him and turn him into a homosexual and you turn into a communist. If you weren't around for your children would go and find communists to hang out with and become communists. Or if you were too motherly, which is called momism, you would turn them into pansies and they would become communists anyway. So women had a lot of interesting things. And they weren't just supposed to be good mothers, but they were supposed to want to be good mothers in life. That's supposed to fulfill them. And so it's just like, it's so contradictory, and it was probably drove them insane. And I read some books about it, and it kind of did drive them insane. And then, so one of the interesting stories that I think really, I was actually in a Vice column, I think it was Nancy Gilligan, and she, because that was for like women and teenagers, and a wife wrote in, and I don't think this is a true story, about how her husband cheated on her, and should she divorce him? And Nancy Hill wrote back saying, you know, I think it's your fault. Because if you were being attractive enough, your husband would have done that. Maybe you're being too clingy, maybe you're paying too much attention to the kids, maybe you're not paying enough attention to the kids, you probably don't dress nice enough because you're too distracted by your kids. So just look at what you're feeling as a wife or a mother, and your husband won't cheat on you. And that was the whole advice column. And so that was kind of what was happening for women. And then also, before I get into it, we have the, as you may notice, Camp of Loves over there. And so education for middle class women at this time, it was very acceptable to go to college. But it was not to pursue an academic career or to pursue any kind of career. You went to become a better mother and wife, like prepare you for that. And they had classes on that specifically, but they also, it was like the idea that education gave you like the ability to balance tasks and responsibility and all that kind of stuff. And then also when you got married, that you wouldn't be born to your husband and talk to him. Like you'd be able to carry on interesting conversations. And it was a big fun of the college, apparently. I disagree with that statement.
They prefer to say your MRS degree.
Yeah, and so that's college as well. So you also would have, like, in the bride conflicts, there's a special bride romance conflicts. You would have, like, stuff like the origin of marriage customs, and you have just married, which would go over, like, you know, kind of problems you have early on in marriage. One of my favorite plot lines is where this girl marries this guy, and she can't cook the food that he likes. She doesn't know how to cook chicken and potatoes, and he gets really upset. He's like, can you please go home to my mother for the weekend and let me cook what I like? And she's like, no, I'm not going to do that. That's crazy. You eat my food. And he's like, they get a huge fight, and she goes home to her parents and prays, and realizes that she's a bad wife and comes back and learns to cook chicken and potatoes, and then it's halfway to her after. You know, being from the South, and my grandmother has said stuff like that to me, so it's not completely out. So here, some educational romance comics. So I gave advice. She's wearing a red dress. She's misbehaving. Here we have the story of a girl who goes to college without having proper parental influence. Her father's not around. So this guy, the teacher, is going to teach her how to be proper, and I like that there's another man watching it there. Yeah. I don't think this is going to like put the proper mathematical equation on it. I never seen this happen in college. I can't claim if it works or doesn't. But, okay, so sometimes every father wants to be occupied with business all the time. Lack of fatherly influence. A girl likes to feel her dad is sometimes something more than an animated textbook. So then she gets in a fight with the professor, and she tries to get him to fall in love with her, and then he's like, oh, I've been taken on a sleigh ride. I don't like it. And then he's like, just what do you plan to do about it, Mr. Taylor? Just this, and they never knew anyone who deserved it and more. How true that old axiom is, spare the rod and spoil the child. I'll bet if your parents had given you a regular dose of this, say, once a week, you wouldn't have turned out to be such a brat. And so so she decides to get back at him by becoming really good at math. And she's like, I'm just going to be really good at math and get him to fall in love with me, and then I'm going to break his heart. Except for, of course, she becomes a better person, because if you do your studies well, then you become a better woman.